Welcome back. We're taking questions from across West India to make sure that you choose the right property in your budget. Well, now, Mumbai itself, Sameer, takes up two whole segments, doesn't it? There's Mumbai, there are suburbs of Mumbai, there's Navi Mumbai, there's Thane, and then there are multiple micro markets within.
It will probably be 25% of the entire value of real estate of the country.
Okay, so it deserves that much of attention. Though I must say, we can't relegate all the time Pune and Ahmedabad to the end of the show. So we are going to juggle around, but here's a question for another city of Western India. Binoy Samuel on the phone line with us. Binoy, go ahead.
Yeah. Hi there. This is Binoy. Mm-hmm. And I am basically looking to buy a property of 3 BHK in Baner, Pune.
All right.
And my budget is around 1 to 1.25 crores.
All right.
I'm not very sure if I'm going to use it by myself or I might just keep it as an investment.
Okay.
But I'm certainly looking at a ready-to-move-in property and under-constructed ones as well.
Okay, so both choices he's given us. Baner, in fact, Pune market, if I look at all the data, has withstood the slowdown the best.
Well, it has, but I want to share that with my viewers that Pune market has really slowed down as we speak right now. Mm. Over the last 4 months, there's been a big slowdown in Pune, and that probably creates an opportunity for you to really jump in and start buying over there because you can get great deals.
It's a good time to buy in Pune, absolutely. So.
Baner is a fantastic micro market. It's got best of both the worlds, proximity to the main area of Pune, as well as the proximity to Hinjewadi. It's got great social infrastructure already in place and good connectivity. The inventory overhang, that's why, is 23 months, lower than the danger zone in these markets, is supposed to be excellent. 7,000 rupees being the weighted average price for the mid to luxury segment over there, and the price appreciation has been about 10% on an annualized basis. Yuthika by Paranjpai Schemes, all reputed developers, and we've given you a combination from ready to under construction. You can choose any one that you like. 8200 to 8600 rupees. It's a big project coming up with 16 towers to be delivered in phases. Amenities inside are like two clubhouses, open amphitheater, swimming pool, jogging track. Phase 1 with 11 towers already ready and occupied. So that's a big plus. Aurelia by KBD Group at 6750. So that's why it's lower. A tower is ready over there and occupied too, but this is getting ready next year, 2016. Amenities here are also decent. Clubhouse, swimming pool, indoor games. Located off the Soos Road, 1.5 kilometers from the Mumbai-Pune highway. Lastly, we have Park Express Phase 2 by Pride Purple Group. This is a project which is spread over 10 odd acres. So very good size from Pune point of view, because Pune also has many small projects also. Phase 1 with 10 towers is ready for possession and occupied. Amenities here include also a clubhouse, gym, swimming pool, jogging track, etc.
All right, so that's the quick summary of the projects that you can look at in Baner, budget 1 to 1.25 crores. And I would say that yes, the next couple of months will throw up great opportunities and good discounts in the real estate market. So if you're eyeing property in any of the key cities of India, this might be the best time to step out. On the other side, Pritesh Modi writes in and he says that, hello, Property Show team. First, thanks for hosting this program. Pritesh, thanks for watching it is all that I can say. It's always good to get feedback. He says that I'm working in Pune. I'm a software engineer, but from Gujarat, Ahmedabad. So I would like to find a property in this city. I'm planning to buy a new or under construction 2 BHK apartment in Ahmedabad. Budget is 40 lakh rupees. And he's given a long list, Sameer, of areas that he likes, making your job very easy. Paldi, Vasna, Ambavadi, Nehru Nagar, Dharnidhar, Dersar areas in Ahmedabad. So he's not living there. I think it's just an investment.
He's made it very easy because all these areas are unaffordable. So we didn't have to think much about these areas at all. Paldi's weighted average price at 5,000 rupees a square foot. So there's very little that we can offer you over there. The right micro market of choice is Bhopal, actually, where you can get projects keeping your requirement in mind, where the weighted average price is 3,300 and the inventory overhang is 26 months. Not that much of a cause of a concern with the slowdown in India anymore. Paldi, of course, better location, more expensive, still attracts a good appreciation of 10.5% on an annualized basis, followed by Bhopal at about 9-odd%. So there was a project that you also shortlisted, Yash Pinnacle by Yash Realty. It's a go-ahead from our side, but due to price constraints, it will be out of your budget. So if you can muster up that kind of money, then you can go ahead with this project. The recommendations from our side are in Bhopal, Orchid Divine by Safal Realty. A project much affordable, 3,000 rupees a square foot, with good amenities like a fully equipped health club, swimming pool, mini home theatre. Construction is yet to start in the next 2 to 3 months, ready in 3 years. Located 2 to 3 kilometers of Sun City and the Amrapali Mall. Lastly, we have Gala Glory by Gala Infra at 3,500, consisting of 3 towers of G+ 13 stories. Amenities include central garden, health club, multi-purpose court, located 100 meters off South Bhopal, besides Gala area.
All right, so Bhopal it is. That's what you can afford in your budget, and the list of recommended projects is on that list. So go ahead, take a look, and of course, choose the one that you like the best. That brings us to the close of today's West Edition. Sameer, thanks very much for taking all our questions. Well, all that we can say is don't forget to tune in every Wednesday for all the buzz and top properties worth your money in Western India. Reach out to me on property@ndtv.com or on my Twitter handle. Goodbye, and thanks so much for joining me. We'll be right back.